shortest odds to win the title. Currently plus 260 at Caesars Sportsbook, while the next shortest odds belong to the Lakers at 6-1. Warriors at 7-1. Not a lot of buy-in, I guess, in Vegas at the moment. Bucks 8-1. Only other team shorter than a dozen to one, which is where Utah is to round out the top five. Some more context on your league leaders. Golden State, they rank first in scoring and third in scoring defense. Last team to finish a season in the top three on both ends, 95-96 Chicago Bulls. In his 13th season, Steph Curry leads all players with a plus 195 plus minus. On a per-game basis, that's on pace to pass Draymond Green from the 15-16 Warriors team for the best mark by any player in a season in the play-by-play era. If you're interested, that dates back to 96. Curry also leads all players, 76 threes. Most through 14 games in a season by any player all time, passing his own mark of 71 in that same 15-16 season. As promised, JJ Reddick back to give us more context on this. And you're a man that fairly said made your living shooting a basketball, top 20 all time in threes made and in three-point shooting percentage. And I want to dive into Steph, but first I want to show you something here. I want to see what you remember about this night in particular. Is it any clarity about this night?
I know exactly what this night is.
What is this night?
It's my 1-9 three-point game of my career.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you went for 40.
It was also the only 40 ball I had in the NBA.
Really?
Yeah.
So a 40 piece and nine. You say it was the only 9-3 night I had, as if that, like, nine's a lot in a game, isn't it?
Not if you're Steph.
Well, to that point, as you continue to rein it in, I mean, is it like the cliche where it looks like the ocean, like one of those things?
If every shot felt good that night, every single shot.
But to the point, not for Steph. You did it once in your career. Steph's done it three times in five games, I should say, 37 times overall. You look at the other guys that are close to him, and all these guys can get red hot. But what I'm looking for here, JJ, is just as someone who did this,
yeah,
what are we looking at? What explains what he's doing at this level?
From my perspective, the best way you can describe it, he's tapped into a higher level of consciousness. I'm being serious, though. There's something that some zone that he's in more than any other player. And for the most part, he's in that zone all the time. Think about even last night.
Mm-hmm.
Last night, he's got 37. He's hit 9 threes.
Yep.
There's MVP chance. The crowd is begging him to shoot the ball.
Mm-hmm.
There's a foul. He's going to check out of the game. He tosses it up two-hand, and the ball goes in. It's kind of like when you've got that perfect buzz and you just know you're going to make the last shot on beer pong. Steph's in that mode at all
times. I was going to say Neo in the Matrix, but the beer pong reference makes just as much sense. I think about it this, though. Like, I think about great shooters. Like, if Reggie came off a screen and got his shoulder squared, fine. If it was Ray in the corner, forget it. Certain players, if they're in rhythm and they step into it. But what's the scout with him? Because I don't feel like there's any one thing. It's just sort of everything. If you're trying to stop it, what is it you're trying to do?
That's a great question. He's gotten stronger. He can play more physical off the ball. But look, he can go left. He can go right. He can go off the dribble right. He can go off the dribble left. He can turn right. He can turn left off down pits. He can do everything. He can shoot any which way. And it's not just the shooting. It's the imagination. It's the daring. It's the freedom. He's just out there playing free like no other player in my generation.
And I think that there's a certain gift that greats are given. But then it's how hard do you work to make it just truly transcendent, which is, I think, what we're seeing. And to that point, I was struck by this last night, JJ, and you spent a lot of time in this league. When Jordan used to go into the Garden, like, it was his building, even though he's wearing a road jersey. And I know Patrick and the Knicks are like, hold on now. But he would make that building like, ooh, right? From the first three. The Nets have a couple MVPs. They were there to see him. How long a list are we talking about of guys that can go in another building on the road and it's their building?
Right now?
Right.
Two. Him and LeBron. Him and LeBron. But I would say this right now, Steph is the greatest show in basketball. If I were to ask you,
right,
you had $100 to take you and your friend to a basketball game.
Mm-hmm.
What game are you going to?
I need to sit on the wood, my man. I need more than
okay,
100.
Okay, all right.
I don't need to tap into your wallet.
You need to win a couple bets.
Yeah, tap into your wallet. No, but I understand what you're saying. No, I think
if you're an average NBA fan.
It's him.
Because
I think, for me, the reason is because he does the thing that you did, and which is, people can't relate to the idea of rising up on somebody and punching it on them, but we've all shot a basketball, but he shoots it in a way that's just different. And from the minute, it looks different. Like, right? It's just the way it goes through the net looks is different. And I feel like from the very first one he hit, he lit the fuse in that building last night, and that was it was done for.
He feeds off of it, too. There's a joy that he plays with.
Mm-hmm.
It's infectious. It's infectious to everyone in that arena except the opposing team.
Mm-hmm.
It's infectious to his teammates. You see the way they respond to his game
when
he gets
not?
It going. I never got to play with him. I assume it'd be an awful lot of fun to be on the Warriors with him. The scary thing is when Klay comes back, Steph's getting more open looks.
Yeah.
There was this incredible stat that I read. There was like a 4 or 5 year stretch. This is when I was playing for the Clippers and with the Sixers. There's a 4 or 5 year stretch where the two guys that got the most wide open threes in the NBA
mm-hmm.
were Steph and Klay. So think about that.
Right.
Shooting begets shooting.
Yep, no doubt.
Yeah.
And he's going to come back.
Yeah.
Good times. Thank you so much for being here.
Of course.
Fancy new suit, by the way. You didn't have to go do that. You didn't have to go get just a new suit for us.
Got it today.
A message. At the beginning of the game, when you walk across half court and you pull up for three and you pump up the crowd, that's sending a message in their house. He made 9 of them yesterday. And the Warriors won by 30. It was not even a game. The best team in basketball showed KD that they got better without him. The 2 years they were able to repair themselves and didn't make the playoffs. Klay and Wiseman still aren't playing. They're now in a better position going forward than KD's Nets. And was James Harden playing? Did he look interested? If James Harden is interested, they should just rest him for a month.
He looked apathetic.
They should just rest him for a month.
He looked apathetic.
Was James Harden playing and did he look interested are two different questions, unfortunately. But let's go back to Michael Wilbon. Is Steph Curry right now the best player in the NBA?
Ask him, Greeny.
Yeah. Yeah. But look, if you had tiebreaker in mind that you needed one, last night was a tiebreaker. Mm. Yes. And you know what? There's something. Jalen referred to this a while ago. There's a certain joy that the Golden State Warriors play with.
Yes.
That everything around it, we've been to their practices, we've been to their shoot-arounds, maybe not recently because of COVID, but this is, it's back if it was ever gone. And I'm sure it was to some degree. You had those serious injuries, particularly the ones to Klay.
Mm-hmm.
But they have that joy about them. And I didn't see that or sense that in my time around the Nets. Maybe you guys have. You've been around them more. Mm-hmm. There's something about that. Steph Curry. Steph Curry brings that to work. Yes, Iguodala being back, he brings it as well. But that starts with the best player on that team.
There is no disagreement. The reason why there can't be a disagreement is because when we say that, we're not just going by what we see on the court when it comes to guys of that talent level. KD is a superstar.
Yeah, yeah.
So is Steph.
Mm-hmm.
The difference is Steph is a better leader. KD was in Oklahoma City. There was a struggle with leadership with him or Russell Westbrook. KD goes to Golden State. He just played. Clearly, he didn't have to be the leader. There was Steph Curry. There's Draymond. KD followed Kyrie to Brooklyn. It wasn't the other way around. So in his career, he's now, even though he's a champion, an extraordinary individual, player, et cetera, et cetera, mm-hmm. he's never shown that he's the guy that will carry a franchise on his shoulders, which is why so many people were saying LeBron is better. Steph Curry, in the year that he had last year without Klay Thompson, the 2 years that they've struggled, has elevated. And then last but not least, when you look at Poole, Toscano, Lee, Gary Payton II, and all of these other guys, these are guys that have elevated their level of confidence because they're around this guy. Yet never fail to be deferential. You see guys throwing no-look passes. Everybody, it's always to Steph Curry because they know where to find him. They know he's the priority, and not a single solitary soul has a problem being deferential to him in any way. They love him. They respect him. They admire him. And most importantly, they play for him. Whereas with KD, he usually has to carry it himself because that level of leadership doesn't necessarily galvanize folks to go all out.
But we're giving James Harden a pass on that.
But
we're giving James Harden. James Harden been the MVP of the NBA. Right.
Steph
He's
Curry.
That should be equal recently. Shouldering.
Yes.
Steph Curry was a unanimous MVP. And